Good evening. How are we doing? I think this is going to be the start of it. We apologize for being a few minutes late. We do like to be as punctual as possible. We thank you all very, very much for being with us this evening. It's going to be a fun evening. This we guarantee you. My name is Chuck Rodiker. I'm from Touche, and I'd like to welcome you to Touche. On behalf of Bob Maddox and Frank Goley from Malehide Leathers and myself, we hope you have a real good time with us this evening and welcome you to the third annual international, Mr. Chicago Leather. Hopefully he'll be the winner of international, but Mr. Chicago Leather. And it is the third annual. Unfortunately, it hasn't been consecutive. It's been 2 years since we've had our last one. And these last 2 years have been real eventful. Not only for Touche in particular, but for the leather community in Chicago in general. We thank you all very much. For those of you that are aware of it, of course, Touche burned down a year ago March as a result of an electrical fire. And we relocated up here. And thanks to your support, we've had a real fun year and look forward to many, many more up here in Rogers Park. We'd like to say particular thanks to all of you that have taken the time and energy to participate tonight. And as the evening goes on, we want you to have a real good time. And also remember, when it gets time for people to talk, to give them some courtesy too, because the person that wins tonight not only represents Malehide and Touche, but they also represent each and every one of you in the Chicago leather community. So enjoy yourselves tonight. We've got a few surprises. We hope that you all have a real, real good time. And this time I'd like to welcome a couple of very good friends of the leather community and Touche that have, again, given of themselves this evening. A lady who's been very, very active in the leather community, one who's a member of OROC, which we'll tell you a little more about later, but it stands for Open Road Riders of Chicagoland. And there's our motorcycle group, yes. And not only that, but also represents is the current Miss North Halsted Street Leather from Manhole on Halsted Street, who went on to win the 1991 International Ms. Leather. So shortly I would like you to welcome Miss Kay Hallinger, and with her will be a friend of all of ours, RJ Chaffin from RJ Video, but who's better probably known to a lot of you as the coordinator for International Mr. Leather and the owner of Backdoor Productions. So if you haven't gotten a ticket for International Mr. Leather yet, I don't know, but I guess you're gonna have to talk to RJ or whisper in his ear or something as far as getting one. So at this time, I would like to welcome two very special people, Ms. Kay Hallinger, 1991 International Ms. Leather, and RJ Chaffin from Backdoor Productions.
Hi, good evening. How you doing tonight? I'm RJ.
And I'm Kay.
Just want to make sure y'all know that right away.
Now take notes. Test follows later.
Well, we're excited tonight. We got some really great looking guys downstairs. I know you're not going to be disappointed at all for being here tonight. And we got a few things to tell you. First is reading of the rules. Now, this is real short and simple because there are no rules. So, how about that? We like short and simple things. AK.
And I'm going to tell you what the contestants are going to be judged on. They're going to be out in front of you twice. On the first go-round, the judges are going to be looking at their macho look and their leather image. That seems a little redundant to me. And the second time is going to be their swimwear. Oh, come on. We know we don't swim in leather. And their personality, right?
I swam in last night.
Well, I heard you were into water sports.
Are my water wings showing? I am available tonight, by the way.
Now, RJ is going to tell you what these fantastic men are going to win.
What are they going to win, you might wonder, and some of you might not. The big prize is that all three of our winners will win a pizza from Frank's Pizza Shop. Is Frank out here? Well, we hope Frank's here. That's the big prize. Our third winner, our second runner-up, third place, will win $50 cash and from Touche's, and also $50 gift certificate from Malehide. our, you know, second place winner, first runner-up, will win $100 cash from Touche and $100 gift certificate from Mailhide. And first place winner will win $250 cash, $250 gift certificate from Mailhide, and will also represent Mr. Chicago Leather at International Mr. Leather here in Chicago in May. And while we're talking about International Mr. Leather, how many people here are going to IML this year? How many here have tickets already or have confirmation letters already? Sorry, guys. I do want to give you one warning that we are basically sold out on the contest already. And the scary thing is, last year in May, we sold about 750 packages, so we don't know what we're going to do with these people yet. But if you have not purchased tickets, standing room only tickets are available now, but you have to call the main office. I believe there are brochures around the bar. But I would suggest if you want to go to the contest that you better do that first thing Monday morning. Okay, that's what they're going to win. And I guess we're ready to bring the guys out.
And see what they wear.
And see what they wear.
Or don't wear.
Oh, I guess we should tell the guys what they're being judged on. Do we do that now? Yeah. No, let's do that
I
now.
I did.
Yeah. Who cares? Anyhow, the guys are being judged. And that's Kay's. That's your territory.
I did.
Did you? Oh. Can I have a shot, please, or a joint? You said this?
Macho look.
Okay.
And the leather look. See, he got carried away with that swimwear.
That's right. Sorry, no drugs tonight. I just
honey, punishment
this
follows
sober.
Later this evening.
Yeah, well, that's what we're going to do. We're going to introduce the judges now. I'll take the first judge. Judge number one, Sam Olson, former owner of Sam's. Here, how many remember Sam's? Bunch of old queens. Also was co-owner of Sundays. And today is one of Chicago's most famous bar personalities. That's nice for her. She's a party girl.
And it is my pleasure to introduce Peter Thomas, who shares a building with my hostess and hostesses, and they argue over which one is which. Peter is president of Mid-America Conference of Clubs and a founding member of Open Road Riders of Chicagoland. Rodeo riders, pardon me. This is Peter.
Our third judge is Sheldon Harrison. Raise your hand, there we go. Sheldon is the director of Open Road Riders of Chicago, and he may not be seen most of the time, but he's usually down in the sewing dungeon at Mailhide. Our fourth judge is Alan Naparella. And Alan is Mr. Windy City 1990 here in Chicago. And also we'll be talking to you a little bit later about his new video adventure he has coming up. Ooh, oh, now. You take your clothes off, Anna? You take your clothes off?
No.
No, you don't take your clothes off. There goes your airtime, doll.
And with all due respect to the four male judges, this next one is my gender preference. This is none other than the first AA Meat Market female contestant, Ms. Leather from there, won in 1990, but you really are going to carry through for 91, and was a most worthy competitor, although I like to think of her in other ways. Darcy was a second runner-up at International Ms. Leather when we were both out in San Francisco a short 5-6 weeks ago. So Darcy.
And that's our judges for tonight's contest. If we're lucky, we'll be all tangled up by the end of the night. It'll be wonderful. Something for me and Darcy here. Okay, we're ready to bring our contestants up. Coming up to the stage, contestant number one, Chuck Windemuth. I do apologize if I can we have a little bit of music, background music, a little enigma or something. Yeah. Okay. Oop, get out of your way here. Chuck is 32, weighs 204 pounds naked. 6 foot, how many inches? How many inches, Chuck? Okay, 6 foot. Chuck is a top. Occupation is International Flight Service Manager. And his favorite piece of leather is his top harness. You want to parade a little bit for us, Chuck? Show the judges and the men what they're here for? Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number one, Chuck Lindeboot.
Contestant number two is John Gillick. John is 34, 6'2", 190 pounds, and he will be whatever you want him to be. He's a waiter and a bartender. He's also still in school. And on the application, we ask for other titles, and he says his title is, whenever he goes into the bar, they say, "Ooh, Daddy." So that's his title. His favorite piece of leather is his jacket. Parade it around, John. All right, let's hear it for John. Thank you.
Okay, these guys like to, you'll make a lot of noise, really get these guys going here, okay? The more noise, the more you see. Oh, it's Mr. Windy City 1989 here. Hi, how are you doing? Good, good. Okay, contestant number three, Bill Dacus. Bill is 31, 5'8". Bill's also a top. His occupation is nursing home administrator. Do you tie those old people up? Only if they want to be. Bill's favorite piece of leather is a full harness and black boots. Contestant number three, Bill Dacus. That's better.
Contestant number four is Bob Turnout. Bob is 34 years old, 155 pounds, 5'7", and he is a bottom. Now get his occupation, honey. This takes some explaining. Credentials analysis. You analyze people's credentials. Now these people are here to analyze your credentials. His favorite piece of leather, he's got two, harness and handcuffs. Are your handcuffs made of leather? All right. This is Bob, contestant number four.
That was contestant number four. You okay? You okay? Okay. Do we have
next,
any?
Next, he will be in a full body cast.
What's the problem? Okay, contestant number five, Pat Stevens. Yo, baby. Pat's 27, 165 pounds of flesh. 5 foot, 10 inches. He wears his keys in the middle, so you figure it out. He's a chemist. Yeah, okay. And his favorite piece of leather is his armbands. Is that sweaty armpits? Oh. Yep, that's sweaty armpits. Contestant number five, Pat Stevens.
Contestant number six is Kevin Smith. He's 27 years old, 150 pounds, 5'10", and he plays it both ways. He is a banker. I'm getting all the rich ones. His favorite piece of leather is his vest. Parade it around, Kevin. This is Mr. Ameritrust. Thank you, Kevin.
Okay, our contestant number seven is David Katzenberg. David is age 23, 200 pounds, 6 footer, goes both ways, top and bottom, of course. His occupation is chasing me around the video store, you bad boy, you. Catch me, catch me. Now, his real occupation is file room supervisor at a law firm. I may talk to you later. Okay, and David's favorite piece of leather is his chaps. Oh, I think there's a quarter down there. You better bend down and pick it up. Attaboy. Contestant number seven, David Katzenberg.
Contestant number eight is John Morehart. John is 30 years old, 160 pounds, 5'9". His preference is for butch men only. And you play it both ways? You just like to play.
Yes.
I think we discussed this earlier. His he works as a bartender. Now, get this, he is a title holder. The title was in Toledo, Ohio. Are you giving them a good view? And it's Mr. Scratch and Sniff. of 1986, and he hasn't washed since. His favorite piece of leather is his motorcycle jacket.
Did you scratch? Did you scratch it?
No, I had my hands full.
Okay, contestant number nine, Gary Vesey. Did I do it wrong? I know I did it. Close enough. Okay, Gary here is 38, weighs 180 pounds, 5'10", and he's also both top and bottom. Gary's sign is slippery when wet. How moist. Occupation is security consul. Anyhow. And favorite piece of leather is his harness. You want to show us all your harness? Yes, no. Number nine, Gary.
And our last contestant, number 10, is Michael Fottenhauer. Michael is 36 years old, weighs 160 pounds, 5'10", and he is a top, and that's all in capital letters. Honey, I understand what you're saying. Oh, what's this in parentheses? Oh, you could be a bottom with a special person on special request. His occupation is artist. And his favorite piece of leather is his jacket. Can we see what's under the jacket? Oh, the merest suggestion. All right, thank you. Let's hear it for Michael. Thank you.
Well, that's our contestants for tonight. Another round of applause for all 10 of our contestants. Okay, now we have a little entertainment treat here for you. We have a gentleman here by the name of Steve Elstein. You might know him if you are familiar with the Millie Orchid shows at the Park West. He also goes by Monk, the One Wing Wizard. Let's bring Steve ready. Yeah. Okay, now you might want to stand back because there's a little fire here, so. My little scarecrows. Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Elstein. Thank you, Steve. Before we take a real short break, Alan, can you? Alan wants to tell you a little bit about a video project that he's involved in. And keep it clean.
Real quick. Me and a partner of mine designed a video called Butts and Guts. It's a 60-minute exercise video in conjunction with Howard Brown and Chicago House, with portions of the proceeds going to benefit Howard Brown and Chicago House. So if you see it on the market, and you know, you can work out in leather, you can work out whatever you want. I don't care what you work out in. Even if you don't work out, it doesn't matter. You know, the proceeds go for a good cause. So pick it up if you see it. You know, all right. Thank you.
Thank you, Alan. I worked out once, but I worked it back in. Okay. Oh, Rich, can you make me thinner? Thin. Oh, farther. Back. Farther. Go down to manholes. Okay. We're ready to take a short break here. Okay. And give me about 15 minutes while the guys are switching over to their. Mr. Renslow. Good evening, sir. I got on my hands and knees, but you know, had it bow lower. No, say no to crack, honey. Okay. Anyway, we're going to take a short break. We'll be back in about 15 minutes with the guys in their swimwear. Oh, look at high.
If we can have some lights, we're going to get back to the business at hand, shall we say. Hey, how you doing? We've got Leather United here tonight. RJ mentioned, or perhaps it was Chuck mentioned, that my affiliation here in Chicago, in addition to representing Manhole and Vortex at the International Ms. Leather Contest, was that I'm a member of the Open Road Riders of Chicagoland. In many of the gay rags, that is identified as OROC, and I think a lot of people don't know what that is. OROC, Open Road Riders of Chicagoland, is one of the few gay lesbian motorcycle clubs in the nation. Most of the, shall we say, homosexual motorcycle clubs, the H word, are gender specific. You've often heard of the Dykes on Bikes out in California. They even scare me. And many of the men's gay motorcycle clubs do not allow women. And I am very proud to be with a co-ed, gender non-specific motorcycle club. So aptly led by our director, Sheldon Harrison, one of our judges tonight. And some of my brother bikers are standing right over here in proper uniform. Many of you may have noticed our schedule that we put out at many of the bars, all of the leather bars certainly. And you may think that if you don't have a motorcycle, you cannot be among us. And that is a fallacy. Fallacy. Don't you like fallacy?
Nice word.
Nice. Well, let me set your fallacy straight. If you just like to ride with bikers, then just look on the schedule. We meet at Mail Hyde, usually at 10 o'clock. Some of our rides are on Saturday, some of our rides are on Sunday. And what you need to do is let us know ahead of time so that we can be sure that we can have a seat for your buns on our bikes. And you're more than welcome to join us on those rides. We love having buddy riders. Yes. The schedule is at the front door. We've got a ride to Milwaukee on the 12th, which happens to be Mother's Day. And you can just join the mothers in OROC. And we've got another ride scheduled on the 25th of May, coincidentally with the IML activities. So please look at the schedule, call the phone number, make your reservation. We would be more than glad to have you. For those of you that do have motorcycles, we only need that it be a 350cc or above and in good working condition. And they've never told me if the bike has to be in good working condition or the biker has to be in good working conditions. Perhaps both. I would like now to bring back my co-host, RJ. Oh, RJ, you changed clothes. Oh, honey, now you're gonna look better than me. This is Bush.
This is Bush. I'm wearing my very tasteful manhole t-shirt. Listen, as you can see, the owners on Halsted Street are at it again. I have a great idea. I think we should take all the bar owners of Halsted Street, line them up at Cornelia or Roscoe and Halsted. In one big line, they all drop their pants, and the one with the biggest dick wins.
And that's RJ's fantasy.
No, I know the bar owners. It's not my fantasy. Oh, and I love them all. I love them all. I have to love them all. Anyhow, and I love manholes, too, by the way. One of my favorite bars. Mm-hmm. Yeah. She loses. Okay. Also in the audience, I'd like to recognize a very, very good friend of mine who's taught me a lot of things in the leather business here, Mr. Chuck Renslow. He was just here. Where did he go to? There he is. Okay. Executive producer of International Mr. Leather, the man you might want to talk to if you need those seats down front tonight. How about it, Chuck? Okay, I guess we're ready to bring the guys back up.
In their swimwear.
In their, oh. Contestant number 11, it's downhill from here, guys. Okay, we're ready to bring you guys up. You guys ready? We want to hear a lot of noise.
The water's fine.
And deep. Okay, contestant number one, Chuck. Chuck's athletic interests are bodybuilding, no shit, and running. Likes to play football. His favorite fetish is his chest and tit work. He needs some more work on those. Okay, and his favorite fantasy is watching Senator Jesse Helms licking his boots. Slowly. Okay, all of our, stay up here, Chuck. All of our contestants are going to be asked one question. We'll need to lower the sound when we do the questions. Thank you, sir. And the question for all of our contestants are, what does Chicago and leather mean to you? Now, I know this is kind of a slow spot in the show, and it's like, but just think of it this way. You get more time to see the guy in the swimwear. And also, when competing in this contest and also going on to the International Mr. Leather Contest, how they speak and what they speak about is very important. Okay, Chuck?
Well, first of all, what Chicago means very much is the very best in the leather community, and not only just in the Midwest, but from one coast to the other. Chicago represents the very best. And what Chicago leather means is a group of men that are going to show people from all over the world that when Memorial Day weekend comes, that we are the number one leather community, and we are going to bring that title back to Chicago, every one of you. And you're going to show the world that Chicago leather is number one. Thank you.
Thank you, Chuck. The audience was very good. A round of applause for you guys for keeping your mouth shut for 2 seconds. It was wonderful. Very good.
All right, we're going to bring back contestant number two, John Gillick. John's athletic interests include weightlifting and running. His favorite fetish is a three-way. And his favorite fantasy, John, I'm the boss. Now you're going to have to do a little gender changing here. I'm the boss. And John wants to be called in to the office by the boss. John is in his shirt and tie and three-piece suit, looking so much like the loyal employee. And the boss asks you to what? And John provides those services and gets paid for it. Oh, you slut. You slut. Let's see you in your swimwear. All right, let's hear it for John. The boss says you can go now. Oh, I'm sorry, you do have to talk to us. Right.
First of all, what Chicago means to me. Coming from the East Coast, I moved here 3 years ago. What it means to me primarily is when I first got here, I couldn't believe how big it is because I came from Boston. I mean, it's immense. Second of all, being that I'm an artist, the architect, I think it's one of the most beautiful cities architecturally in the country, easily. And also, too, after living here for 3 years, I've like discovered that first year I hated it here. I couldn't get used to it. I couldn't get used to the difference of people, you know, and things like that. And now I've learned to love it because what I love about it is it's a mingling. It is Midwest. It's the real Midwest. I never understood what the Midwest meant until I came here. And what it is a conglomeration of people, you know, from everywhere. You know, it's great. As far as the leather and Chicago goes, I think it's got a lot of potential. I think it's growing. I think it's going to get bigger and bigger and better and better. And I think that look at the bars that are opening in the city and the amount of people that are supporting the gay community and the leather community and the leather community alone, how it's supportive of the gay community as far as AIDS research and this and that. And thank you very much.
Thank you, John.
Okay, our contestant number three, Bill. Bill's athletic interests includes weightlifting and softball. His favorite fetish is my shaved balls being tied up and played with. And favorite fantasy is motorcycle ride into the country. And motorcycle ride into the country.
Finding an abandoned barn
and setting it up like a playroom with five hot men waiting for action. Sounds good to me. Okay, John, you want to tell us what Chicago and leather means to you?
Hi, I'm Bill, and it's been an honor being here. The group of guys downstairs, the camaraderie is just absolutely wonderful, and that's why I wanted to be here this evening. Chicago and leather, I think, is synonymous with Touches. Touches is internationally known. Last month, I was in Amsterdam, and I was in the cock ring, and there was a poster of Touches, and I smiled. And somebody said, what are you smiling for? And I said, I'm from Chicago, that's my bar. And they said, ooh. And, you know, and I think that's exactly what Touches represents, and I think that's what the leather community represents. Touches, we're here, we're friendly, we're here to stay, and everybody knows us, and that's what I think our leather community is all about, being recognized favorably. Thank you.
Contestant number three, Bill.
Contestant number four is Bill Turnout. Bob. Bob's athletic interest is athletes. His favorite fetish is nipple play. His favorite fantasy is two straight men chasing him, jacking off, and forcing him to service them orally. Is this your fantasy?
More than you know.
Bob had the incident with the stairs back there, and doesn't he look good in red? What does Chicago mean to you, and what does leather mean?
Chicago means anything. Anybody can come here, find what they want, what they need, diversity, freedom to be whatever you want to be. Leather is a break from that two-piece pinstripe suit with the white button-down collar and color power tie of the week. And the chance to just be able to look like this in front of a lot of really good-looking men, from what I can tell. Lights are bright. Leather is just, for me, makes me feel good. I guess that's all I can say. And as you can tell, I'm willing to humiliate myself as well as let myself be humiliated.
Okay, contestant number five, Pat Stevens. Pat's athletic interests are working out, tennis, swimming, and biking. Favorite fetish is nipples and raw sweat. How those armpits doing? Yeah, they're getting riper, okay.
Oh, I have to.
Oh, Favorite fantasy, a group scene with me and three other guys. We would pair off as couples, with the second couple mirror imaging our every move.
Oh.
I love orders. I fucking love orders. With sweaty armpits, I love orders. Okay, and thrust for thrust and smack for smack. Okay. You ready for your question? You ready to leave the stage? Okay. Pat, you want to tell us what Chicago and leather means to you?
I made the 150-mile trip about 3.5 years ago to Touche. I live in Kalamazoo, Michigan. It was a long drive. I wore my tank top, jeans, tennis shoes, and a hat. Not a leather hat, but I think it was a corduroy hat. I felt kind of like a fool, but everybody welcomed me. Even though I wasn't in leather, everybody came and talked to me. They were very friendly. I felt like there was a sense of community here. And I felt that way ever since. I've come a long way. You've all helped me evolve. And I appreciate that very much. That's what Chicago means to me. And so I come here about once every 2 weeks, 150-mile drive, but I make it. Thanks.
Contestant number five, Pat Stevens. Thank you, Pat. We'll work on that fantasy later.
Contestant number six is Kevin Smith.
Woo!
Looking sharp, Lieutenant. Kevin likes running and swimming. His favorite fetish is burly men with distinct accents. Can they fake it? His favorite fantasy is being pulled over by a policeman in full leather. And he goes down on Kevin in the squad car in lieu of giving him a ticket. Has that ever happened to you?
Fortunately not.
Ah, dream on. The question, what does Chicago and leather mean to you?
I started coming out about 5 years ago, and I was living in Champaign. And at that time, I was a lieutenant in the Air Force. And it, as you can tell, it was very hard coming out at that time. And as I evolved and started moving to Chicago and coming up here more and more often, I felt very, very uncomfortable in the normal gay life. And it wasn't until I started going to Touche, where it was on Lincoln, that I started feeling like I found a home and I found accepted for what I was and who I was. And at that time, I started gaining friends that I will cherish forever. And it's really, that's what leather means to me. I've gained a very good commitment amongst the leather community, and they've accepted me for who I am, and I felt very committed to who they are and accepted them for who they are. That's what Chicago leather means to me.
Very good, thank you. You're dismissed.
Hey, contestant number 7, David. David's athletic interests are working out and wrestling. His favorite fetish is wrestling for position. His favorite fantasy is having the chance to wrestle anybody I wanted to for position with my choice, with leather to win or lose. Ready for your question? Okay. I'm gonna tell the audience what Chicago and leather means to you.
Well, Chicago means my home. For me, the Chicago leather family is very diverse, and it's very comfortable. I can walk into any bar, you know, any leather bar, or any bar in the city, but any leather bar and feel right at home. I came out around five years ago. I came out in Los Angeles. It was very funny. I kept cruising Midwest men. So I moved back. What leather means to me is it's a way of life. You know, I believe in comfortability. You know, and this is very comfortable. I have the right to say or do whatever I want to, or what I don't, you know, I have the right to say no to anybody. And that's something the leather community gives. I also believe the unity in this fellowship is outstanding. With all the clubs and all the bars and, you know, all the controversy with the bars, you know, it's all part of Chicago. But, you know, it's what makes Chicago, Chicago. Thank you.
Thank you, David.
Contestant number 8, John Morehart. John's athletic interest is weight lifters, not to be confused with weight lifting. His favorite fetish is older men. That could be defined, I suppose, as anybody over 30, 40, 50.
Starting at 35.
Now, this man is a man of intellect. He is into Shakespeare. His favorite fantasy is, well, roughly Shakespeare, a rough session with Mel Gibson, who is in his Hamlet leather gear in the dungeon in Denmark. with medieval instruments of torture. And Hamlet is saying in true Shakespearean, fuck me, Hamlet, fuck me. I don't remember that in English class. Are you ready for the question? What does Chicago and leather mean to you?
Well, tonight, good evening, women and men of leather. I'd like to say three things. First of all, number one, I'd like to say when I asked my friends to come tonight, I invited them over for some cheap booze, and while I was in the shower, they said, you know, John, why are you going to be in the Touches contest? And I said to them, you know, just flippantly, I've serviced the leather community for the last 3.5 years, and it's about time I get recognized for it. Number two, I just wanted to say that I've been a volunteer for Open Hand Chicago for the last 1.5 years. And when I go there on Friday nights and deliver meals for 2.5 hours, I see men of the leather community there supporting Open Hand and volunteering. You are the men out there that are doing the work. You're our backbone and you're our support. And number three, I just want to say that I've worked in 10 different bars in the last 3.5 years in Chicago. About 7 of them gay, and 3 of them, you know, kind of. But of all the bar owners that I've ever worked with, Chuck is my favorite. And I don't know where you are, Chuck, but Chuck is the number one bar owner in this city, and I mean it, and that's why I'm here tonight. Thank you.
Okay, contestant number 9, Gary. Gary's athletic interests are bicycling and weightlifting. Favorite fetish is tickle torture. Easy for you to say. Favorite fantasy, interrogating spread eagle marine recruits. Any marine recruits out there? Anybody want to be a marine recruit out there? Ready for your question?
I think Chicago has always been very prominent in the leather community, and I want a chance to represent this community in Chicago to help show everyone that leather people are not quite so bizarre and have the stigma that everyone attaches to it. I think that the straight and the remaining gay community needs to wake up and realize that we're just like everyone else, and that's what I want to show everyone.
Thank you, Gary. Number 9, Gary.
Contestant number 10, Michael Fottenhauer. Michael's athletic interest is the MSA softball, for which he is a pitcher. What do you pitch? To whom do you pitch? He pitches the balls to the boys. His favorite fetish is in the sling, and his favorite fantasy is 5 men. I kind of thought you would have gone for 9, take on the whole team. 5 men on latex, oiled with warm oil, and me in control. Ooh. To stir the oil in case it gets a little stiff. Remember the question?
Hello. First of all, Chicago to me means opportunity. I moved here 3 years ago and I became a graphic artist. And there is a lot of art and culture in this city, and I've taken part in quite a bit of that since I've been here. And leather. Leather is relatively new to me, but boy, I sure love putting it on. And I can't think of a better city to learn how to wear leather well. You gentlemen do it quite well. Thank you.
Thank you, Michael.
That's it. Okay, we're going to bring the guys back up for one more look if they're ready. Do you have any athletic interests?
Yes.
What's that?
Yes, I have athletic interests. I'm a runner. I'll chase anything.
Oh. I have an
athletic. Until it catches me.
I have an athletic interest too.
Oh yes, what's yours?
Jumping to conclusions. It's an old joke and I'm an old guy, so what can I say? Okay, we ready to bring you guys up for one more round? I'd like to welcome Jeff McCord here from Windy City Times, publisher Windy City Times. Hi Jeff, how you doing? Okay, come on up, guys. This is our parade of the contestants. Mr. Chicago Leather. Okay, the guys will be back in a few minutes. Thank you, guys. Watch your step.
And I believe you're going to bring the magician back now, right?
Yeah. We're going to bring the magician back for another little set here. He's going to break dance. While on a fire stick, while in a straitjacket. Now, I need two volunteers to come up to the stage. Do I have any volunteers who would like to come out there and hand pick? I pick you. Come up. What? Okay, we'll have two. Kate? Okay, Kate? You're going to stay on board here. You're going to help strap him up. And who's our second person? Come on. You're going to help him strap him up in a straitjacket. Well, we got a guy here. Just be careful coming up stage. Hi, how you doing? What's your name?
Mike.
I had a feeling it was Mike. Okay. If you two want to stand over here until Steve is ready for you, let me bring back on the stage Steve Alstein. Need a mic stand for that. Let me take this one over here.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Hey, aren't those contestants terrific? Yeah, they're all good sports, too. Very friendly people. And I want to thank you all very much for that warm reception you gave me earlier. Okay, pleasure meeting you. Mike, nice meeting you. I'm Monk. Excuse me for not shaking hands. Let me explain a little something about the straitjacket. This is a regulation straitjacket. And please notice that the buckle, just one in the top here, buckle is all the way in the final hole and then through this little piece of rope loop that keeps it secure. Would you like to examine the jacket? We'll waste a little time here.
It's been used before.
Oh, yes. I use it a lot. I've become known as the only man in the world who break dances his way out of a straitjacket. That's the crotch strap. Be nice. Be nice. Okay, let me bring the mic up here a little bit, and if you'd hold that out. All right, now we're all going to turn around so everybody can watch you buckle those buckles here. That'll be fine. You might want to start at the top and work down.
Yeah, the buckle hanging straight down is the one that'll go for the crotch strap. All right, now the crotch strap. This one does not have to be buckled quite so tight, please. Woo-hoo! Oh, gee. Yeah, just that's fine. Yeah, we'll get to the sleeves in just a moment. All right, we're all set back there. Great. Now, Mike. You want to do that again? Mike, would you make sure that my arm is in that sleeve? Is that me in there? Would you grab the end of the sleeve, the strap, and pull to my left? Be careful you don't fall off the stage, but pull that, no, toward you. Pull toward you. And Kay, would you do the same on your side? Make sure that I'm in there. I'm not David Copperfield, I don't cheat. No, it's not Tagore. Just pull it taut. Very good. Now I'm gonna step back from the mic so you have some room, and then I want you to come over this way, and then you'll come around that way. Thank you very much. Kay, would you wait just a moment? I'm going to ask you to move the mic away from me in just a moment. Mike, would you want to step down off the stage? And let me keep this. I'd like to call your attention to one more thing. Please notice that my wrists are in my armpits. This is regulation straitjacket securing. My arms are not down at my waist. They're not one on top of the other. They are interwoven. Okay, are we ready? Music, please. Thank you very much. You're a wonderful audience, and you deserve applause yourself. Thank you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, Stephen Elstein. Okay, before we take a real short break while the judges are ready to tally those votes, I need to bring Tom Demkowski up to the stage. Tom is a lot of things. but he's one of our good buddies at IML, and he has a couple old things to say to you.
Good evening. I just wanted to say thank you to the leather community again for its support for the community organizations that are helping in the fight against AIDS. As some of you may know, in the past few years, with International Mr. Leather, we raised money in a variety of ways. Mr. Renslow donated his wig one year. I've had my head shaved. We've auctioned off posters. This year, we're going to try something at the Leather Marketplace, which will be in the penthouse of the hotel. And we need your help in that. We're going to try to do a flea market of recycled leather, non-intrusive toys, denim, porno, whatever you've got to give up. We want to recycle that for some of the younger people in our community because they could afford it if we resell it. And I've always been asked over the years for those who are gone what we could do with their leather. So this is a way to make a good use of it and to also help the Dan DeLeo Fund at the Howard Brown Memorial Clinic. So if you've got anything to donate, you can drop it off at the Brown Elephant or call me at Howard Brown. There's some flyers at the front door. Thank you for your continuing help.
Thank you, Tom. Okay, we're going to take another 15-minute short break, and we'll be back with our winners. And also that same weekend is the full moon party, is an IML full moon party. That's on Tuesday, May 28th. And our good friends at Mailhide want to remind you that if you need some last minute fixing up or you need some leather goods, that you better shop early because they're going to get real busy now. And finally, I'd like to do some thank yous here to our crew that helped put all this together. We have Rich Davies on camera back there. We have Eddie Kamen on camera back there. I think he's back there. There he is. We have Scott here helping the guys off and on the stage. You did a wonderful job, Scott. We'll get beat later. And we have Shelly Rosenbaum from Madison down there, and also Fred Walls somewhere down there. I think he's still down there being busy. Okay, that's and also our good friend Jerry here. Where's Jerry at? There's Jerry. He did a lot of work for this beautiful stage. I'll tell you, I'm impressed. Okay, we're ready to bring on the guys so we can get a winner here. Get just some serious partying. Come on up, Chuck. Little music, please.
Are these men hot or not? Yeah.
Okay, let me up front here, please. Excuse me, pardon me, excuse me, pardon me, excuse me, pardon me, excuse me, pardon me. Okay, to the left. Oh, you motherfucker. As we're gonna thank the judges in a minute. Sure. Okay, we're ready to announce the winners, right?
And I understand you have the sealed envelope
that
has
sealed
been
envelopes.
Certified by the accountant firm of our trustworthy co-workers.
We need Jerry Musleave up here. He's the manager of Touche's. Okay. We're going to let Jerry make the announcement for the second runner-up, third place.
And Gary, number nine, Gary Vespa.
All right, Gary.
Okay, I'd like to bring up to stage the lovely owner of Mailhide, one of the co-owners of Mailhide, Bob Mannix. Hey, Bob. Bob's here to announce the first runner-up, second place.
Glasses off. Now I can't do it. And the first runner-up is contestant number five, Pat.
Yeah. Congratulations. Okay, before we get to the final winner here, let me thank my judges, our judges.
You're just going to tease them and tease them.
Why not? We have all night. Where did Sam go? Hello, Sam. Are you down there? Oh, there he is, at the bar. Yes, our favorite Chicago bartender, Sam. We also got Peter Thomas. They're here. Sheldon Harrison.
Oh, I gave my list away.
Alan Naparello. And Darcy. Thank you, lovely. Okay, are you ready?
I'm ready. Do we get a drum roll?
Drum roll. Okay, you ready?
And the person,
the man
who is going to represent Touche and Malehide and the International Mr. Leather this year.
And win a 16-inch pizza from Frank's Pizza Shop.
I understand Chuck says that the size pizza that they get corresponds to, what was that again?
My lips were busy when you were telling that. Right?
Let's not delay any longer. The winner
The winner of the Mr. Chicago Leather 1991 is contestant number
one, Chuck.
Well, let's see him lift me up. Let's give a round of applause for our contestants. They were great, every one of them.
Thank you.
Okay, I think we need to keep the winners up here for more photographs. We want to thank you all for coming tonight, and we still got another couple more hours to party. Lots of partying, so stick around and we'll see you later.
All of you should be back to keep this up, all right?
We have your number.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Thank you.
No, you got to keep at it. At it.
Before you take pictures, though, let's hear it one more time for our two MCs tonight. RJ Chafin and International Ms. Leather 1991, Kay Hallinger. Thank you.